Hi, everybody. You know, post-lunch sessions and then starting with the committee is fine. So the last session was about 3C, and now we are shifting to 3Ts. In communication, what we call the 3T, which we work on, are truth, trust, and transparency. Interesting panel. We've got His Excellency also from Bangladesh, and of course from Mumbai, Girish, and Mumbai now Delhi, Stuti, Aman hardcore Delhi, sitting in the center of a lot of action these days, Jamia, and Pranav. I mean, half the time he spends in Delhi, and I don't know what he does internationally, but interesting. You know, in these days, what we just saw in the past earlier, I mean, what Mr. Pashicha was saying, that how things are changing, and it's days of Pummi Auntie and more. So before the panel, I think it's important to understand that communication today is very dynamic. While we are talking, we need to tweet, that's there. We also need to keep checking our emails, that's a part of the job. When we are reading newspapers in the morning, I think still some people still do that. We're still engrossed in other activities. And in that, if you see, how do we manage truth? How do we manage trust? And finally, are we transparent for our clients? With that, I think one of the important stuff is that if we need to really see that in the digital age of disruptions, where organizations, their business goals change. If an Uber comes, whole auto industry shakes. A lot of guys who were in the auto transport, they need to relook. With every OYO, every Taj hotel needs to relook at their business. Now imagine, with these kind of challenges, how do we communicators, we work? Is that in today's time, can you control the communication? It's just like this. You can't control what's happening around. But what we can control is our communication. And for that, I think it's very important that we need to control our narratives. Girish, I think we were talking just before the panel that in today's time, it's very important that can we relook at communication in a different perspective? Can we actually see that if we need to measure something, do we have a metric? And considering the stakeholder inside a corporate various, so just throw a light on hum bade hain, you know, to manage truth, can we measure?
I think one of the key things that's happening today is many organizations are following, within an organization, they are following different sources of metrics. There's no one source of truth. So the CMO would be following a different matrix. The CCO would be following a different matrix. The HR department is following a different matrix. Everybody has their own matrix. And if there is no one truth of measurement that comes along. And as peers would often agree that when we get a brief and we deliver the brief and we go and present it to the CEO, we see a completely different point of view suggesting that this was not the brief, this is not the goal that my business wanted to achieve. Now that's where the dichotomy comes, right? Because the CEO or the CXO is really looking at the matrix from PR or comms and from a different lens, whereas we are delivering it basis a brief through a very different lens. So who hum bade ho or who's bada, I really don't know, right? The fact is that if you can deliver the business goal and deliver the business objective and collaborate with all CCOs, CMOs, etc., I think that's where really measurement will drive, and that's what PR, that's how PR can be effective.
Interesting. I mean, the collaborate, I mean, again, coming back to, I think, Pummi Auntie, 3C is something which still rules. We need to collaborate. Pranav, I want to come to you. You have been managing a lot of clients, international and desi clients, if I call. One of the key things which, taking from Girish, he said that it's important that the stakeholders, they have some common metrics. So if it's a CXO from the HR level, etc. Do you think that the C-suite, their expectations level, okay, even if we set the goal, but is the expectation level set according to the business goals? I mean, the context which I am is, for a HR person, it could be like best company to work for. I mean, how many of you actually get your clients to participate in those best companies to work for? The show of hands. Yeah, so now that's there. Now, if we take from a CFO, if the merger acquisition is happening, it changes. So Pranav, from that perspective, how do we set for the C-suite some common objective, the narrative part?
That's a very good point. I'm going to step back for a few seconds here. So I think there's a bit of a chasm between marketers, communicators, and the C-suite in some sense. Maybe they don't see eye to eye. Well, rather they do see eye to eye, but there's a very different sense of metrics that they want from their marketing or their communications campaigns. And I was doing a bit of reading for this panel earlier, and there was a survey by a group called Proof Analytics, which is a platform that we use globally for metrics and measurement. I'll talk about that later. But there was a big gap in how the C-suite wants and what is marketing's understanding of that. So I think in some sense that, you know, measurement and objectives is a both a marketing and a communications challenge. That chasm can only increase over time. But I think when it comes to your question, Anup, on how do we give it some common metric, I think we occupy a very important seat on the table as communications, and as what public relations does. And I think that metric has to wear beyond, you know, just the numbers, but to the factors of trust and credibility. You know, how is my brand transparent, authentic, and how do I engage with my audiences, you know, in that manner, but also where we offer a certain value proposition for our customers and, you know, the broader audiences overall. So I think trust is probably one of the key factors there.
Trust, I mean, I think, can we have the video too, please? That's all. This Aman, I mean, I think we'll come to you on this one, primarily from the perspective that, what is trust? Why do we come? So this is the new way of gaining trust. TikTok. How many of you watch TikTok videos? I don't think many hands will show in this one, but I'll tell you the lot of corporate communication and marketing brand guys, and Stuti, you will be in a better position to add on that later after we finish with Aman. So now people are shifting to building trust stroke the engagement through these TikTok. Tiger Shroff does it, and then people take it to the next level. So Aman, I'm coming to you that with this kind of things happening, how do we measure trust? And why do we so obsessed with measuring trust or the credibility or the results?
So I think I will address the fundamental question of measurement first, which was pretty much the panel about. It's an eternal debate going on as to how to measure PR campaigns that we do or communication campaign we do. And many a times, the yardsticks are pretty much the same that they would have for, say, Google Ads or for the advertising or, you know, for a lot of other things that these people do. Now, it's a very important for people to understand that what exactly PR or communications do for you, okay? So PR and communications actually comes into the picture when your digital campaign creates the inquiry. The main conversion, when that happens, when the client actually makes the purchase decision, that's where the trust and the credibility of the brand comes into the play. That is where PR and communications play a major role. So when you have to measure, you have to measure trust, you have to measure the credibility, and honestly speaking, it is not easy to measure. I mean, there are a few organizations like Edelman, and I really like their trust barometer, if anybody is here from Edelman, where they actually measure the trust in different institutions as well as corporate brands. So I think if the trust is to be measured, credibility is to be measured, you will have to look at long-term objectives and the campaigns that would have run. I mean, you cannot say 6 months down the line, what is the ROI on my campaign? Because if it is working on trust, if it is working on credibility, it has to be long-term. So the objective setting has to be accordingly, and measurement then also has to be according to that.
Yeah, I just want to add one thing. While it's great to measure trust, credibility, whatever, I think more often or not, one of the things that we get missed out is, do we establish the goal right before the campaign? Okay, and how are we going to measure that, whether it's a tangible or intangible, and have we agreed upon that? One, and are we going to keep measuring it quarter on quarter to show evidence of the fact that, you know, communications really is playing a role? Like Aman mentioned, right, you put a Google ad, you know what kind of impact you're going to generate. What's the evidence that PR can generate? I think that's where the rubber does not meet the road most often or not. And we go into a tizzy more often or not. And I hate the word AVE, but that's our best measurement matrix for the last 20 years in our industry, right? And that's not great. It's not great because it doesn't take into account many aspects of tonality, of reach, audiences, page, visibility, so on and so forth. So I don't think that we are establishing the goals right up front to really start talking and having a conversation with the CEO on intent rather than a task.
Pranav, I'll come to you just before. Show of hands, again, Asim is here. I think they work on a fabulous model of measurement. Show of hands, otherwise, how many of you are actually in whatever may, struggling from the AVE perspective, the number, the volume? Any PR guys? What kind of? So now that's a change. I'll tell you.
This is actually because there may not be so many agency guys here.
No, but
because if agency guys were here, everybody would have raised their hand because this is a problem we are facing every day.
Yeah. No, so the point, Pranav, I'll come before we move to Stuti, is that the thing was coming that earlier the budgets were coming from the marketing team. The marketing team, the brand guys, they used to depend on advertisement agencies where the numbers were very clear. But in our case, PR, so if the genesis is that the funds primarily used to come from the advertising budget, stroke the marketing team, pardon me, not advertising budget, the marketing team, it was there. So Pranav, just make a point and then we come to Stuti.
No, I just want to make a point that I think it's also important to go beyond trust. And we spoke about how consumers buy and purchase. So what is the, you know, the funnel or the cycle? So I think it's also incumbent on us as, you know, agencies working with the clients to really understand that where does PR sit in that funnel, right? So what is that conversion and how PR can really help? And then we can measure beyond trust on very specific metrics on how we are, you know, translating to sales. And then I think as technology becomes more advanced and we have more tools at our disposal, I think there are certainly ways and means in which we can start to measure, for example, how does mentions and impressions turn into sales, right? I think we should get to that point where we are able to specifically point out that our, you know, PR campaign efforts actually yield very tangible outcomes beyond just trust in some sense.
Valid point. In fact, I mean, we are very happy that, I mean, Stuti typically works. I mean, in our conversations, we found that the campaigns which you take, it's what the new age communication is more about storytelling. Puri, while we were discussing, you said that how digital is now taking the shape.
So it's all about storytelling and content. So how is the audience receiving the information? How do they access it? Do they digest it? Is there an understanding of it? So it needs to be engaging. So today I was actually brainstorming with my young team in the office, and let's say we have a client called Crocs, and now they want to influence the celebrities. And if you're seeding something, you know, let's say to a celebrity, and they sort of talking about it on social media, and there could be Insta stories. So you know, the matrix is changing. And someone asked me in the team, so how do we differentiate between a post versus a story? And so we cannot have something which we were doing a few years back. We have to keep evolving how we do the matrix. And we launched a hotel last year, and you know, we tweeted the press release. So it had a different sort of impact. And that was something which was talked about, how storytelling, digital, and how you're influencing the landscape, which makes the difference. And it needs to be engaging, mostly.
Sorry, one of the most recent storytelling example, and I have a friend sitting over here, and you will hear the person after us, is what Ford has done with poetry, And I think that's a fantastic way of storytelling. Does it reach the audiences? Does it talk about the product? Does it give you a feeling that you really want to buy, that emotive presence of the car? I think it does all three. And it's not necessarily we follow the same tools of PR, which many of us have learned, but yet have not forgotten. So I think it's time to really rethink and recreate forms of storytelling.
Yeah.
And one of the
and
prime examples,
each,
as I said,
brand
is of course.
Would have a different form. So like, you know, for a particular audience, it could be like an Instagram. For someone, it could be TikTok. And yes, of course, there is traditional. But it has to sort of evolve, and it needs to be a combination of both traditional and digital, at least in the PR space.
So, I mean, very interesting, like both Girish and Stuti said that we need to evolve. And imagine, you know, coming from Stuti, that my young team, younger, imagine like a, now the, just see the just imagine, no, but Stuti's saying young team, imagine like she's so young, and that's the way the communication is changing. So that's the dynamics. And here I would say, like, I mean, console, if we can have the video three, please.
It's impressive how Maggi has handled its instant noodles crisis. In fact, there are many lessons government could learn from Maggi in crisis management and communicating with the public. One, when charged with adding MSG to Maggi noodles and elevated levels of lead, Nestle India didn't start abusing the credentials of the FSSAI. Two, instead of...
So, how many of you had Maggi in the last 6 days? Yeah, see, that's the change. If I had asked the question a few years back, you will have to go and check. So, I am a generation which grew up on Maggi. So, ours is a very different case. And Adil, my friend from Bangladesh, he manages a similar kind of brand, which incidentally I was also associated with Coca-Cola. So Adil, you were mentioning that in your country, more than 60% of the people are young. I mean, like, Stuti minus age kind of stuff. So for that, the bells always ring. You know, I mean, like, these guys are panicking. They keep needing, I mean, like, there's no time. Like, while we're sitting, the bells will ring. So just help us, like, in whatever time they can give. What do you think in your part of the world, how things are happening with the youth, and how do you measure campaigns?
Thank you. The context of Bangladesh is slightly different. It's not largely different because of the audience is very evolving audience. Below 25 is 60% of our population. It's one of the young nation in the South countries. So previously, one of the speakers, Debashish of Tata Trust, was telling that the media is everyone now. So the conventional media and the digital media and other media, these are all measurable. But when it comes to individual, from all Facebook users, is a media now. So now the challenge is, how do we actually monitor or do some measurement preemptively so that the communication doesn't go wrong? So there are some bad posts are coming randomly. It's very difficult to preempt. So sometimes we need to prepare with ourselves to contain that. So media is no longer just number of publishers. It's media is every individual. So that's more challenging, and that's more measurable thing coming days for us to meet.
Very interesting. So I'll tell you what the interesting format of this event is. This was the first part. The second part, we're going to take questions on Instagram and Twitter. Our hashtags and Twitter handles you can find there. So that's a wrap up on the stage. Next, we'll catch you online. Thank you very much, everybody.